Now time for book reading. Introduction. We know that everything that occupies space and has mass is called matter. Do you know what is matter? Is composed of? We have studied earlier that matter is composed of tiny little particles which cannot be seen with naked eye. In this, we will study about atoms, molecules, elements, compounds, chemical formula and atomicity. Okay. Next. Atoms. Graphite lead used in pencil is made up of an element is called carbon. We can break graphite into smaller and smaller piece. If we have finer knife, we can break it even smaller. If we keep cutting the minuscule graphite into smaller and smaller particle, we will reach a point where we get the smallest constituent of graphite, that is carbon atom. If we break the carbon atom apart, the properties of carbon are exhibited. The smallest unit of element that exhibits the properties of that element is called atom. All matter is composed of tiny particles called atom. Water, rice and everything we see around is made up of atoms. An atom is the basic unit of a matter. Next, this is the structure of atom. Okay. Next, even with the best optical microscope, we cannot see atom. However, there are advanced instruments that help us to imagine the atoms on the surface of a material. For example, the following figure shows the image of the surface of silicon. Next, do you know the most abundant atom in the universe is the hydrogen atom? Nearly 74% of the atoms in the universe are hydrogen atom. However, three most abundant atoms on the earth are iron, oxygen and silicon. Next, molecules. When atoms combines with another atom or atoms and forms a compound, it is called molecule. A molecule is made up of two or more atoms chemically combined. First is oxygen. Oxygen gas in the air that we breathe is made up of oxygen, two oxygen atoms chemically combined. This is two oxygen atoms chemically combined. Next one, ozone is a substance that is made up of three oxygen atoms chemically combined. Next, an atom of oxygen and two atoms of hydrogen combine to form a molecule of water, that is 2H2 plus O2 gives 2H2O. This is the structure of water molecule. Next, molecules also exhibit the properties of matter and have individual existence. A molecule can be formed by the same or different kinds of atoms. Molecules can be classified as below. A molecule which contain only one atom is called monoatomic molecule. Example, inert gas. Second, a molecule which contain two atoms is called diatomic molecule. Example, oxygen, nitric oxide, hydrogen. Next, a molecule containing three atoms is called triatomic molecule. Example, ozone, sulfur dioxide, carbon dioxide. Next, a molecule containing more than three atoms are known as polyatomic molecule. Example, phosphate and sulfur. Next, molecules of elements. A molecule of an element consists of fixed number of one types of atoms chemically combined. Table 3.1 shows that gases are made up of two atoms of the same element. Next, molecules of compounds. Molecule of compound consists of a fixed number of different types of atoms chemically combined. For example, let us look at the model of water molecule below. Each molecule of water consists of one oxygen atom and two hydrogen atom. The ratio of oxygen and hydrogen atoms remains fixed whether water is in liquid or solid or gaseous state. This principle applies to the molecules of compounds. Compounds with different atoms are given in table 3.2. Listen carefully. Listen, molecule diagram. This is example for molecules of elements. Two chlorine atom, two oxygen atom, two nitrogen atom. Same atoms combined to form molecules. Okay, this is ball and stick method. Chlorine molecule, oxygen molecule, nitrogen molecule. Next, compounds of different atoms. Molecule diagram, carbon dioxide, ammonia and hydrogen chloride. This is molecule model, that is ball and stick method. Okay, that's all. Okay, now time for material reading. First question, write the chemical formula and name the elements present in the following compounds. First one is sodium chloride. Chemical formula is NaCl. What are the elements are present? Sodium and chlorine. Okay. Next, potassium hydroxide. KOH is the chemical formula. In this, potassium, oxygen and hydrogens are there. Okay. Next, carbon dioxide. Okay, carbon dioxide, in this chemical formula CO2, in that carbon and oxygen are there. Next, calcium oxide, that is CaO, in this calcium and oxygens are present. Next, sulfur dioxide, in this chemical formula SO2, in this sulfur and oxygens are the elements. Okay, is it clear? Okay, next, second question, classify the molecules of element or molecules of compound. Oxygen, O2 is a molecules of element. Okay, because same atoms are there, no? Same atoms in fixed ratio means that is molecules of element. In this CO2, OCO, this is different types, no? So this is molecule of compound. One carbon is there, two oxygen are there, no? So that is molecule of compound. Molecule of element means same atom in fixed ratio. Molecules of compound means different atom in fixed ratio. Okay, next, nitrogen molecule. Let us consider nitrogen means same atoms are there, no? Same atoms in fixed ratio, so this is called molecule of element. Last one, NaCl, different atoms are there, no? So this is molecule of compound. Okay, next question. Third question, what do you understand by chemical formula of a compound? What is its significance? A chemical formula is a symbolic representation of one molecule of an element or compound. Okay, it is just a small definition. Next, define the following terms. First one, element. What is element? Elements are the simplest form of pure substance. Example, oxygen and hydrogen. Next, what is compound? Compound, the atoms are two or more elements combined chemically in definite proportion. Example, water and carbon dioxide. Next, what is metal? Metals are generally hard and shiny. It is the good conductor of heat and electricity. Example, zinc and gold. Non-metal means, non-metals are generally soft and dull. It is poor conductor of heat and electricity. Example, oxygen and hydrogen. Exceptional case is there. Metal, hard and shiny are there, no. But one important, that is sodium, okay. Sodium is the soft metal, okay. In this non-metal, one important one is there, that is diamond, okay. Diamond is the generally non-metals are soft and dull, but diamond is shiny and hardest substance. Okay, one more thing is graphite. Okay, one more thing is what? Graphite. That is, graphite is the one form of, graphite is the one form of carbon allotrope. Okay, it is a non-metal, okay, but it conduct electricity. So these are the some exceptional case of metals and non-metals. Okay, next, metalloids. Metalloids exhibit the properties of both metals and non-metals. Example, boron and silicon. Next, write the symbols of the following elements and classify them as solid, liquid and gas. Aluminium. Aluminium symbol is what? Al. Classification, aluminium is a solid, no. Okay, next, carbon. Carbon also a solid, symbol is C. Chlorine, Cl, symbol is chlorine, it is a gas. Okay, next, mercury, symbol is Hg, it is a liquid. Hydrogen, symbol is H, it is a gas. Helium also gas, it's a symbol He. Next one important question is there, that is, classify the following metals, non-metals and metalloids. Listen carefully. Sodium. Sodium is a metal, in that sodium, bismuth, silver, iron. These four are metals, okay. Nitrogen, carbon, chlorine. These three are non-metals. Only one metalloids are there, that is silicon, in the given question. Okay, is it clear? Okay, next one important 5 mark is there, that is, explain the characteristics of compounds. Okay, first one, a compound is formed only when the constituent element combine in a fixed proportion. This is first one. Second point, it is different from those constituent element. This is second one. Third one, a compound cannot be broken down by physical method. This is the third one. Okay, next, first point, another compounds fixed proportion la irundha அதோட கன்ஸ்டிடியூண்ட் எலமெண்ட்ஸ் ஃபிக்ஸ்டு ப்ரொபோர்ஷனில் இருக்கணும். தட் இஸ் ஃபர்ஸ்ட். ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட்டு கன்ஸ்டிடியூண்ட் எலமெண்ட்டோட ப்ராப்பர்ட்டிஸ் காம்பவுண்டோட ப்ராப்பர்ட்டிஸ்லேருந்து வேரி ஆகும். தேர்ட் பாயிண்ட், காம்பவுண்ட் கேன்னாட் பி ப்ரோக்கன், ஃபிசிக்கல் மெத்தட்ஸ் யூஸ் பண்ணி ப்ரோக் பண்ண முடியாது. நெக்ஸ்ட், இட் இஸ் மேடப் ஆஃப் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் எலமெண்ட்ஸ் தட் ஆர் கெமிக்கலி கம்பைன்ட். ஓகே, லாஸ்ட் பாயிண்ட், இட் கேன் பி செப்பரேட்டட் கன்ஸ்டிடியூண்ட் எலமெண்ட்ஸ் பை chemical method only, not in physical method. We can't use to separate by using physical methods. Okay. Next, one important assertion reason is there. Oxygen is a compound. Statement 1. Statement 2, oxygen cannot be broken down into anything simpler. அப்படின்னு சொல்லி கேட்டிருக்காங்க. ஓகே, வாட் இஸ் த ஆன்சர்? போத் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் ட்ரூ. செகண்ட் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் இஸ் த கரெக்ட் எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன் ஆஃப் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட். ஓகே ஓகே ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், தட்ஸ் இட். தேங்க்யூ.